maps you lost.
It's this place where you can sort of ground yourself and we can get a bunch of work done.
Did you hear them yell, land, damn it, land?
Luna's like fast and exciting is almost a little bit too heavy on the artifice side and the insubstantial and the shallow side. I just think that a lot of times it's a lot better to take the slow road. It's like that whole analogy of like freeway versus frontage road. And I would very much rather take the frontage road just because it allows you to kind of, you know, stop every now and then and take a look at things and, you know.
What kind of fish like cigarettes? Have you ever tried using cigarettes for bait?
I don't think the fish are too into the cigarettes.
All right, town cars.
Dude, that was a perfect cast. They're not biting. It's full of them. This is a perfect bass habit. I mean, a perch and stingray habitat.
How'd you hear about this place?
The guy at the tackle shop.
Remember that time I caught that Magnavox? TV, 22 inch.
What a score that was. Yeah. There's a picture of it down at that tackle shop. The best places are like the southern swamp areas, Mississippi. You can pull out a big screen Sanyo. You can seriously, like a 56 inch TV is not uncommon.
Survival out here in the wilderness.
Totally. Those city folk don't understand this kind of stuff. Hey, I didn't even know that pond was there.
Secret Creek.
I think there's some tuna in there, maybe.
Secret Creek.
Can you guys take that cover off that pond for me? It's kind of weird, this barbecue's right in my casting, like my line of casting.
Do.
I'll try.
Should I call somebody?
Do you know anybody that can move this?
I'll try.
Yeah. Try to call somebody. Right. I'll fish around it for now, but I don't want to do this for very long.
Just in time to drive by the big pile of cow dude.
High above the wrecks on ice shelves and dressers, with crash united sewn on all of my dress shirts.
According to my pocket dictionary, this is a fountain.
I think I got one. Yeah, that's a big one.
Is there a net? Here, we got a net. Hold that.
Oh!
Hold it.
Ooh.
Fuck. I'll get it.
Hello! We caught a fish! A fish. A big fish.
Careful, nice careful. One. Hey, hold on. Come on.
Right. Not bad.
Nice one.
What is it?
It's
like a 2 pounder.
It's a soap bottle fish.
What year is that?
99. It's been around for a while.
He's
got the hook stuck. He's gonna bleed. Oh shit. Hey, I got another one.
Did you?
Yeah.
If you're really, really lucky, the lyrics and the music can coincide together and then they can just like become this thing which is like, which nobody could have described or nobody could have predicted. It took me a long time to kind of come to terms with the fact not every song has to, you know, be like groundbreaking or tear you up every time you hear it, but it's nice to have the ability to be able to make a song that's like pretty relevant lyrically and musically. It took me a long time to kind of come to terms with the fact that lyrics are so important. Writing songs is like actually kind of hard. And the worst thing you can do is like sit in your house and just like, you know, stare at a piece of paper. That's like the worst thing you can do. The best thing you can do is just go, brah, and just like, just bust out. Totally bust out, do something you're completely unfamiliar with and throw yourself for a loop.
We're driving out to where part of the recording for Sophtware Slump was done. It's like a pre-production kind of area. But this is where a lot of the basic tracks were sort of farted around with. We got peaches over there on the left, almonds over here on the right. Nice horse stables.
So what do you think's wrong with it?
What do I think's wrong with it? It's like a fuel line, fuel filter. Last time I disconnected this one, this is what I ended up with. Nothing. I drink champagne when I'm working on my truck.
Right, right.
When I'm working on the truck, I drink champagne.
That can definitely be a catalyst.
Let's just have some champagne, we'll think about it.
Troubleshooting.
Should be all right, everything should be right in line.
Nothing.
Nothing?
Nah.
Nothing.
Nothing.
Oh, for real nothing? Shit. If there's anybody out there who's remotely interested in recording or coming up with alternative ways of getting sounds, there's actually one thing that we used on the album, and it's like a real way of getting echo. Out here, there's a lot of irrigation and a lot of underground waterways. Big sort of holding areas for water have this tremendous echo. And it's not as expensive as having to go to some big, incredibly expensive studio.
Sometimes I just want to make love to the sky.
You can do like one of two things here. You can get drunk or you can come up with diversions. In the overall scheme of things, this is a pretty absolutely mediocre place. I mean, there's Walmarts and there's Barnes and Nobles and there's everything that makes or that is making America and all these places like totally homogenous.
Do you guys know how much it costs to camp here?
Have you ever camped up there? We should ask this guy how much it is to camp here.
I don't think he has a permit. I think he's just got a day use permit.
Nice calf.
Huh?
Fish?
Stingrays, sea bass, largemouth, smallmouth, goldfish, yellow perch, green perch, red perch.
Where's fish at?
They're all just under the weeds and like in the little coves and stuff.
I don't know.
This kid says it's $30 to camp here.
Huh? $30 to camp here?
Yeah.
Man, you're crazy if you're paying $30 to camp here. There's a spot right behind the 7-Eleven, 15.
Nice one. Oh, he's little, but he's good. He'll fit in the frying pan. Let's see.
He caught cigarettes.
I got a blue shirt.
Yeah, a pack of smokes. Nice one, dude. I'll take these, kid. Don't touch it. Don't touch it. Eric! Where do these fucking smart-ass kids come from? Poor parenting.
I came from my mom.
The one who watches all that TV, huh? That's okay, though. TV's great.
Hey, you got
lots and lots and lots of TV. Lots of TV.
Storyline. Video. We're making a video. There's all this craziness going on. We're actually right downtown LA right now. Shack. You see right here is spinning through the air and we're playing music in the shack and we get hurled out of what is supposed to be our natural environment and end up in downtown Metro Cosmo land. Apparently we're bewildered and dumbfounded by all that's around us and we're gonna do a little scouting around in the city and just kind of taking in the sights.
And dogs are dead with broken hearts.
So far it's been really funny, with lots of people looking, strange looks, us giving them strange looks back. Away from here. So quiet. By the time the camera turns on, you climb up.